What's up, guys? Today is senior night for the Boston University men's ice hockey team. It's really exciting to get to honor the seniors, but for me it's really sad because it's going to be my last game reporting for the team this season. Their playoffs are going to be away. They're not going to be hosting for the playoffs, and I only report their home games. So tonight's going to be my last game, which is so sad, but I thought it would be a good day to do a behind the scenes video of everything that I do on game day, for getting ready when I get to the rink, for my interviews during the game, and just a behind the scenes of what I do for my job. People message me a lot to see more behind the scenes of like the guys in the locker room and when I write my questions, how I do it, where I am, blah, blah, blah. So this will hopefully give everyone a better sense of what it's like to be a Rinkside reporter for a proficient hockey program. So I usually start getting ready about 3 to 4 hours before game time, and then I usually get to the rink about an hour and a half before the game. So because today is senior day, I'm gonna try to get there a little bit earlier than normal just because we have the pregame ceremony. So I'm getting ready a little bit earlier today. And also it's a 4 p.m. game time, which we never do. The games are always at like 7 or 7:30. So how I do my game day makeup, there's already a video on my channel of my makeup artist doing my makeup, and I just try to like mimic how she does it. Obviously, I'm not nearly as good as you are, Haley, but I just do my best to like recreate it every single game. So yeah, if you want to see what I base my makeup routine off of, you can go watch that video. But this is how an amateur makeup artist does it. So another thing I do while I'm getting ready, usually while I'm doing my makeup, and it looks crazy right now, but I listen to any podcasts that happen during the week with our players or our coaches. So like last night they played at Northeastern, so I usually just watch like the listen to the post game press conference if I couldn't go to it, and it just helps me get the perspective of how our coach thought our team did, and if they get players, how the players thought that the game went. And it usually helps me generate the storyline I want to tell with my questions and my interviews at night. So while I'm getting ready, instead of listening to music, I listen to like all the podcasts that happened during the week and interviews that happened during the week leading up to this game.
It's never ending, it's never ending.
Guys, I love it.
When will it finish? No one knows.
I forgot I shut my camera off after they got here, so I started curling my hair. This is pretty much finished hair and makeup. Just need my hair to fall a little bit and put lipstick on. I've been asked before if my game day makeup and my regular makeup is different. Yes, they're so different. I would never wear fake eyelashes on like a normal day, and I got those wispies in, so yeah. And I usually do my hair like a lot more natural curl. So yeah, that's it. I have my balloons here. Ashley and Kate just surprised me. They got me this cute little gift. But yeah, that's pretty much my hair and makeup. Now I just gotta get changed, and then I'm going right to the rink. So this is my finished senior day look. I got a little red dress on. Started the season in a red dress, ending the season in a red dress. But yep, I'm all ready. I just packed my bag. What I usually bring in my bag is just my computer. So I always have my live stats pulled up. I like to type up my questions on my computer too. I always have a phone charger, a big water, usually snacks, a granola bar, and my pen and paper for when I ask questions. I like to write them down on the paper, and my credential. And that's it. I'm ready to go to the game now.
Just got to the rink, ran into the senior of the night, Julia.
Senior night.
It's really senior night about her tonight, and that's it.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I'm stealing the spotlight a little bit. I'm just expecting to get flowers, let's just say. Yeah.
We're expecting you to go on the ice, and I'll give you flowers.
I'll be playing tonight. Don't worry.
You're definitely putting me on. Don't you worry. Dead. Where are you off to?
The media box.
Over there?
And then, no, the press box, like up top.
Oh.
And then, I'll be back down. You're doing great. We have the equipment room, some of the guys are warming up. Okay. Now we go up to the media press box and we get ready for pregame routine.
Or seventh.
I think they're six right now, but
right
now? Yeah, between like seventh and eighth. Yeah. Hello, thank you. And then we go right into the press box. So I'm in the press box. First thing I try to do, make sure, get my granola bar, get my line charts, know what's going on with our team, with their team. So that's 65 in the game clock. It hasn't started yet. And I just write out my questions for whoever I'm gonna interview pregame. Now we're heading down to the first level where the locker room is to get ready for warm-ups. Media intern, Ryan is our equipment manager. Allie is actually my right hand girl. She saves my life.
We've seen throughout your time here?
Yeah, the grind was really intense, and obviously it shows up there with Chippy's out of play, and there's really a hatred between the two teams, so hopefully we can get them in tonight.
Thank you, Matt. Good luck.
Thanks.
So that was chaotic.
It was so chaotic.
That was absolute chaos. But it always is.
But like more so than it's always, always chaos here. But one down, coach now. This is it.
I'm here with BU assistant coach Len Cannell. Len, we saw 5 penalties total that period. What do you see from your team there?
Well, we want to make sure we're playing disciplined hockey this time of year, especially last night. There wasn't many calls tonight. Too many so far. So we need to be honest.
And what do you think it's going to take for the Terriers to get?
We've got 9:34 left in the second. We're feeling good. We've got 2 interviews left this whole season. 9 minutes left. We're writing them down.
Here we go. You feel good? You feel good.
All right, we're right by the locker room. I got my questions written down. When we get off the ice, we're going to grab them for an interview.
Here we go. Second to last one.
I'm here with BU's associate head coach, Paul Burrow. Paul, can you speak a little bit about the constant physicality that we see in these BU NU matchups?
Well, I think we've played over 100 times in the last 2 years. So these guys know each other. So there's certainly some rivalries going on out there. They got a good team. We got a good team. We both want to win. So that can bring up the physicality.
And what do you have to say about your senior class? How special would it be for your team to pull off a win for their last game in the Indiana Arena?
Fantastic kids and great kids to coach, and it's been a pleasure to have them. And you want to go out strong here in the third.
Thank you, coach.
Thank you.
Just did my last interview.
And now we go and cry because our job is essentially done.
Allie's low-key happy because she doesn't have to deal with me anymore.
I am not happy.
That's a wrap on the season. Thank you, Allie.
I wouldn't want to.
Thank you, Terrier Hockey. My job's over. So that's it. That's my whole Rinkside reporting job. It's so much fun. Sometimes it's a little chaotic as it got during the game, but it's good chaos. I love it so much. It's the best environment. I get to work with the best group of people, and it's honestly the best job in the world. So hopefully this gave everybody a better look at what it's like for me as the Rinkside reporter for Boston University men's ice hockey team.